Claude Code just released one of my favorite features, plugins and plugin marketplaces. Plugins is the super elegant solution for taking all of your custom commands, sub-agents, hooks, and MCP servers and bundle it so that you can easily share it with your team members or the open source community. Not only that, but you can also find other marketplaces and then download and install plugins that were developed by other users. In this video, we'll cover two things. First, I'll show you how to download and use plugins in your own projects. Then I'll show you how to build your own plugins and marketplaces. Plugins are a lightweight way to package and share any combination of your slash commands, sub-agents, MCP servers, and hooks. And of course, you can easily install plugins from other developers using the slash plugin command. And basically, this is what it's going to look like in the IDE. We will have a look at this in the IDE ourselves in a minute. But basically, how this works is you'll grab a URL that contains a Claude Code marketplace and then pass that into Claude Code. This will then show you all the plugins that are available in that marketplace. So you'll simply select the ones you want, and all the underlying commands, sub-agents, and hooks will automatically be installed. And also, moving forward, plugins will be our standard way to bundle and share Claude Code customizations, and will continue to evolve the format as we add more extension points. This really is an important feature for Claude Code. Now, the use cases should be quite obvious. This makes it very easy to share a curated list of MCP servers and agents with your team members. And because these marketplaces can be deployed to GitHub, open source maintainers can make changes to something like the commands or agents to ensure that they are used correctly. And of course, what I'm excited about is the ability to share these different workflows. So when we deploy these marketplaces to something like GitHub, we can share it publicly and everyone can benefit from it. And this will also open up other opportunities where experienced developers can share their workflows and tools with everyone else. So let's actually have a look at using marketplaces and plugins in our projects. And afterwards, I'll show you how you can create your own plugins and marketplaces. In the description, you'll find a link to this GitHub repo. This is a Claude Code marketplace that was developed by Anthropic themselves. We will have a look at this project structure and all the files that make up this marketplace in the next section. But at a super high level, we have this plugins folder, and in here we can see all the different plugins. So we have a plugin for the agent SDK, we have another plugin for commit commands, and this feature dev, PR review toolkit, and security guidance. Of course, when we expand each of these plugins, we can see all the artifacts in it. So for this specific plugin, we have access to custom sub-agents, as well as custom slash commands. If this plugin included hooks and MCP servers, we would see those in this folder as well. And also at the root of this project, we have this .claude plugin folder. And when we click into that, we get this marketplace.json file. This indicates that this GitHub repo is indeed a Claude Code marketplace. So really, all we have to do is grab the URL to this repo. And in order to install this marketplace, what we need to do is type slash plugin, press enter, and here we have a few options. So we can browse and install plugins. And of course, this is saying we haven't set up a marketplace yet. So let's actually go to add marketplace. Then let's paste in that GitHub repository. Let's press enter. So this is loading the marketplace. And now we can see all the plugins that are available in that marketplace. So to select a plugin, we can simply press space, and we can select more than one, by the way. So I'll just select everything and press I. Cool, so we've installed the plugins, and now we simply have to exit out of Claude. Then let's start Claude again. And now when we press front slash, we can actually see those custom commands pulling through already. But let's just simply go to plugin. Then let's go to manage and uninstall plugins. Let's press enter, and here we can see all the plugins that we already installed. In fact, I can see I never installed this one, so I'm going to select it and press on apply changes. Of course, we have to exit Claude again, and when we restart Claude, we now have access to the agent SDK commands as well. Of course, we should also have access to all of the agents, so if I enter @agent, we can see the sub-agents coming in from the agent SDK. the feature dev plugin, and more. Now, in order to uninstall or disable plugins, all we have to do is go to /plugin again. Let's go to manage and uninstall plugins. Let's press enter. And now we can simply disable the ones we don't want and press on apply changes. This just disabled all of the plugins. And if we wanted to uninstall a marketplace, we can simply go to manage marketplaces, open up Claude Code, and click on remove marketplace. So we just have to confirm that we want to remove all of these plugins. Let's say yes. And that's it. The marketplace is now gone. And if we restart Claude, all of those custom slash commands are gone. And we no longer have access to those sub agents. So the example from Anthropic actually didn't include any hooks and MCP servers. But just to give you a quick demo of that, I created my own Claude Code marketplace in my own repository. Now you don't have to install this. Really, it was just part of this tutorial. But if we go to something like UI components, we now have this mcp.json file. And in this file, we can see the shared CN MCP server. So if we wanted to install this, we can simply copy the URL of this repository. All right, so let's open up Claude again. Then just do a double check. If we go to MCP, we don't have any MCP servers configured. Then let's go to plugin and let's go to add marketplace. Let's paste in that repo. And cool. So from this, I'm just going to select UI components and press enter. Let's press enter to install now. And that's it. Let's exit Claude. Let's go back in. And now if I go to MCP, we can see the shared CN component that was installed from that plugin. So currently it's disabled. I'm just going to enable it. And that's it. Now we have access to the shared CN MCP server, all because of this plugin that we just installed. Now that we know how to use Claude Code plugins and marketplaces, let's move on to actually building our very own plugin and marketplace. Then we'll also deploy it to GitHub so other users can install it and use it themselves. The first thing you want to do is start with a blank project. Every Claude Code marketplace contains at least two folders, and that's .claudeplugin and plugins. Claude plugin will contain our marketplace manifest, and the plugins folder will contain all the plugins available in this marketplace. Let's start with the manifest. All we have to do is create a file called marketplace.json. This file contains an object with the following mandatory properties. First is the name of your marketplace. Then we want to provide the details of the owner. This object contains the name and email address of the maintainer of this marketplace. Optionally, you can also provide a URL to the owner's website or GitHub repo. Then we can also provide this metadata object. This contains the description of the marketplace as well as the current version number. Then finally, we have to supply a list of plugins that are available in this marketplace. Each of these are an object that contains a unique name for the plugin, the path to the plugin folder within this marketplace folder. So in fact, at this stage, we can actually create that folder and let's call this website dev. Then we can provide a description for the tool like commands, agent, hooks, and tools for building websites. For each plugin, we can also provide a version, a category, and keywords. These are not actually used by any agents. It simply helps you to organize all of your different plugins. This is actually all we need to set up our marketplace. If you want to add more plugins to your marketplace, then it's simply a matter of effectively copying this object and giving the plugin a different name, creating a folder for that plugin. For this tutorial though, we'll just create one plugin. At this stage, we can test if our marketplace is actually working. So in order to do that, we can open up our terminal. Let's open up Claude Code. And if you recall from the beginning of this video, we can simply go to plugin. Then we can go to add marketplace. And previously we had to provide a URL to the marketplace GitHub repository. Now, of course, we haven't deployed this yet. So in order for us to pull in this marketplace just for testing, we can enter period and front slash. This will look for a marketplace in our current directory. And we get this message saying that the marketplace cannot contain spaces and we need to use kebab case. Cool. So I'm just going to change this to Leon demo marketplace. All right, so let's run this again. And this time it is pulling in the marketplace and we can see the one plugin that we've configured called website dev. Now keep in mind the website dev folder is still empty. So if we try to install this, it simply won't work. So I'm going to press escape to exit out of this. And in fact, to keep things clean, I'm just going to go to manage marketplaces and remove our marketplace. Then I'll press Y to confirm. Now let's set up our first plugin. What exactly are plugins in Claude Code? Well, they're a collection of agents, hooks, MCP servers, and slash commands. So each plugin should contain these objects that relate to its specific feature. For example, let's say you created a plugin that will do security checks on your code. You could then create a plugin called security tools, and then all of the agents, hooks, MCP servers, and slash commands that relate to security will be added to this plugin. Now, a marketplace can contain one or many different plugins. So you could have your security tools plugin, and you can have a separate plugin for all of your UI and UX tools. And we will have a look at adding each of those to our plugin. Now, in order to configure this folder as a Claude Code plugin, we have to create a subfolder called .claude-plugin. And within this folder, create a new file called plugin.json. Again, we'll create an object that contains the name of this plugin. Now, this is really important. This name needs to match the name in our marketplace file. So this name over here, we called it website dev. So in the plugin, we need to call it website dev as well. Then we also have to provide a description. For simplicity's sake, we can actually simply copy the description from this marketplace file and paste it in here. Then we have to provide a version. Again, we can probably just copy it from the marketplace file. And finally, we have to provide this author object containing our name and email address. Really simple stuff. Now let's have a look at adding our first tool to this plugin folder. Within our plugin folder, let's create a subfolder called commands. This is where we'll store any custom slash commands. Now, if you already have a list of commands that you use in your projects, you can simply copy and paste them into this file. But for this tutorial, let's create something really simple and let's call this websitestarter.md. Then for our commands, we have to provide a description. For example, create a basic HTML web page. Then we can provide any prompt we want, like create a simple.html file based on the user's requirements. Of course, these commands can be super complex, but I don't want to spend too much time looking at how to create prompts. This is really about adding our commands to the marketplace. So with this minimal setup, watch this. Back in our terminal, let's run Claude. Then let's go to plugins. Let's add our marketplace. Let's enter .\. Then I'm going to select this plugin and press I. So this is saying the plugin was installed. So we just have to restart Claude Code. And now in Claude Code, when I press \ and type website, we can indeed see our custom command. Now what's really cool about these plugins is if I had to go and create a new command, like generate random names.md, let's add some description like generate random names, and let's just give a prompt like create a list of 20 random names. Watch what happens in Claude Code. If I exit out of Claude Code, then let's go back in immediately. And when I press \ and type website, we can already see the new command showing up, and we didn't have to reinstall the marketplace or the plugin or anything. So what's cool about these plugins is they automatically pull in all the latest changes. This includes changes to the actual prompt. So if I made a change to this prompt right now, the next time I start Claude Code, all of those changes will automatically be pulled from the marketplace and the plugin, which I think is really cool. Now let's move on to agents. In the plugin folder, let's create a new subfolder called agents. And let's create a new agent, and we'll just call this one websitestyler.md. Now, each agent needs at least a name and a description. And optionally, you can also provide the model. For the name, let's call this website styler. And for the description, use this agent to create beautiful styles for our website. This description will be used by the orchestrator agent to figure out when to use the sub agent. Then we can specify the model and I'll simply go with Sonnet. And again, if you already have sub agents in your project, you could just copy them across to the subfolder. So let's keep this really simple. Let's say your role is to Improve the look and feel of a website by implementing proper styling. Ensure that a separate .css file exists and include beautiful gradients and color tokens that work well together. Something like that. Of course, we can add as many agents as we want, but for now, let's simply restart Claude Code. And now when we press the at sign and search for agent, we can see our website styler agent at the bottom of this list. Now what we can also do is add MCP servers. In our plugin folder, let's create a new file called .mcp.json. And in this file, we can add the configuration for our MCP servers, like this shadcn MCP server over here. Because I'm using Windows, I had to add this cmd command, but if you're using Mac or Linux or WSL, this will simply be npx without all the stuff over here. So this means when I start up Claude Code and go to MCP, I can see that the shadcn MCP server is being pulled in because of our plugin. How awesome is that? It makes it so easy to share all of these common plugins with our team members. And finally, hooks. If you've got any hooks that you want to include in this marketplace, again, create a new subfolder within your plugin called hooks. And then within this folder, create a new file called hooks.json. And then simply add in any code related to this hook. Now you can actually do some really cool stuff with hooks, like play a sound whenever a change completes, or even send notifications to your phone. I've got a dedicated video on that that I'll link in the description of this video. How do we share it with the rest of the world? Well, all we have to do is initialize this folder as a GitHub repository. You can do that in the terminal by running git init, or if you're using an IDE, you can simply click on initialize repository. Either way, we now need to create a commit and publish this branch. If you're using an IDE, it will simply ask you what the repository's name should be. So I'll just call this Claude Code Plugins Tutorial and create this as a public repository. And we should now see our marketplace on GitHub. Just to test all of this out, I'm actually going to uninstall the marketplace. So under marketplaces, let's actually remove this marketplace. I'll press Y and that's it. So what I can do now is simply copy this URL. Then let's start Claude Code. And let's go to plugin, let's go to add marketplace, and this time we'll paste in the URL to our GitHub repo. Cool. So we can go back, and now we're connected to our marketplace on GitHub. We can of course install and manage the plugins as we did before, but the important part is if we make any changes to the plugin on this repository, those changes will automatically take effect in our project. How awesome is that? If you enjoyed this video, then hit the like button and hit subscribe to support my channel. I create a lot of content on Claude Code, so by subscribing, you'll stay notified whenever I release a new video. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.